Hi guys, welcome to the interview, and this time we have H4CKer from eStar with us. So first of all, congratulations on the win, and you have gotten the two MVPs for today's game. So my first question is, actually in game two, you have a very gorgeous performance and 100 kill participation rate. And could we know why you guys play so proactively in the early game? Is this the well-planned strategy?
那首先恭喜你们获得本场比赛的胜利。H4CKer 选手也是两连 MVP 嘛。那其实第二局你的表现很亮眼，有100%的参团率，然后且前期打得特别的主动，想问一下，这是就已经定好的一种战术吗？
没有吧，就是在游戏当中，就是我们选到这个阵容的时候，就是这个阵容需要前面去跟他们打架的阵容，然后就我们所有人都有沟通，然后包括教练组也跟我们说，就可以去前面多找机会，多跟他们打嘛，所以就前面比较打得强势一点。
After the ban pick phase, after we have gotten our compositions, we realized that we need to do more skirmishes in the early game in game two. And also our coaching staff, our coaching team has already told us you can grab more opportunities and try to fight against opponent's team in the very early game. So that's why we just have such a game. And also we have noticed in game two, the opponents have chosen Graves. And this champion is a very hot pick in the current meta, but the win rate is very low. It's just around 20%. So what's your thought toward that?Champs.
那其实对面第二局选出了男枪这个英雄，男枪好像这个版本很火热，但胜率只有20%左右。那你怎么去看待这个版本的这个男枪呢？
我的话就感觉就是一个很好用的一个 T1 的打野英雄，然后这个英雄需要搭配阵容，因为他算是一个打野位上的一个没有控制的英雄，所以就需要线上去配合他，然后选到那种控制的英雄。
I still think Graves is a tier 1 jungle champs in the current meta, but it needs the cooperation together with the other teammates. Like for Graves, he doesn't have any CC skills, so he needs some CC skills from other teammates to help him to grab some advantage. And also we have seen you guys in game 3, it's a very interesting stuff for me in the ban pick phase. You have banned out 3 AD champs, but in the first 6 picks, none of you have chosen any of the marksmen. So, could we know the reason for that, or have you already decided you want to leave that counter pick to red to your ADC player?
那么其实第三局 BP 我们觉得比较有趣的是，你们前三手一共搬掉了3个 AD 的英雄，但是你们其实前六手双方都没有选任何 AD， 在没有很多就是热门那个 AD 英雄的在场的情况下，那为什么会这样决策？还是说已经决定好说，哎，我们要把第五手的 counter 位留给我们的 red， 留给我们的 AD 选手呢？
因为比赛已经打到第三把了。然后就是好赢比赛都是主要看 AD 后期的输出能力嘛，然后我们 ADC 就比较自信，他就说就是当被搬了3个 AD 的时候，他就说这把给我选维恩，我要后面选，然后我们正好是红色方，就给了他5楼 counter 位，选了个维恩。
I think we have already played into the game, into the third game, the very last game. I think that is the AD player can carry the whole game. It's very important position. And our red, our AD player, he just told us, you can just give me Vayne because so many AD champs have already been banned out. And we can leave it to the counter pick. You can just give that counter pick to me. So that's the reason for us to make this decision. And my last question is, actually in game 3, around the Baron pit, there's very a bit pity stuff because the opponent's team have stolen that Baron, but you guys just won the team fight. So, could we know what happened there?
那其实在第三局，对面有一点点小小的插曲嘛。对面其实抢到了那条大龙，但你们赢了后续的一个大龙团战。那想一下，当时是发生了什么吗？
当时具体的情况就是，我们五个人在大龙那边，然后看到了对面剑魔在下路带线，然后他们剑魔是没踢的，所以我们选择就是直接打大龙嘛。但是那个大龙血量到那个700还是800的时候，我明明按了惩戒。但我也不知道为什么龙不是我的，就我到现在还挺奇怪，反正我是按了惩戒的。
At that time, we have noticed opponent's Aatrox. He tried to get the lanes in the bottom lanes, so I think it's a very good opportunity to just start it to do the Baron stuff. But at that time, I think the Baron's health is around 7 or 8, and I use smite. But I don't know why. Until now, I still don't know why I didn't get a Baron. I'm still very curious about that. But definitely, I use a smite. Trust me. And thank you. But although that's a bit pity for you guys didn't get the Baron, but you still win the game. And congratulations again. And thank you for joining us. And back to you guys. Bye bye.